Jason O'Mara.
When my time is done, they will say he has been here. That I am sure.
ABC's Life on Mars. The series premiere Thursday, October 9th on ABC.
At U.S. Cellular, we believe you shouldn't pay for the calls.
Hi.
You can't wait to get.
It's the judgment-free zone, and it's only at Planet Fitness, Wilmington's brand new exercise facility. It's more than just the newest health club in town. Planet Fitness strives to promote health in a respectful atmosphere. For over a decade, Planet Fitness has gone to great lengths to provide its members with a friendly space to work out, and there's no contract and no commitment. In the end, it's all about you at Planet Fitness. See for yourself, and remember, at Planet Fitness, you can focus on your workout, not the person next to you.
If you have an antenna TV, the clock is ticking. You have until September 8th to upgrade your TV to digital, or all you'll see is... For help, visit dtvwilmington.com or phone 888-CALL-FCC. Don't lose your TV reception September 8th. Make sure your TV is DTV.
After my accident, we trusted the insurance company, and so we settled on the spot. It was a big mistake. The money they gave us only covered part of my medical bills, and now I need another surgery.
And the insurance company won't pay for that.
I never thought I'd say this, because we're not the suing type, but we should have called a lawyer.
We should have called David and Associates.
If you've been hurt in a car accident, make the right choice. Call the lawyers at David and Associates, 251-8088, 251-8088.
WWAY News Channel 3 will be conducting a 5-minute test shutoff of Wilmington's analog television signals on Tuesday, September 2nd at 7:30 p.m. Log on to WWAYTV3.com for details.
24/7 weather, live, local, interactive.
Good evening and thanks for watching. I'm Megan Torgerson. Hurricane Gustav continues to churn its way toward the Gulf Coast. Officials issued hurricane warnings along the Gulf from Louisiana to the Alabama-Florida border this morning as Hurricane Gustav nears. Meteorologist Sonia Stevens joining us now to tell us a little bit about Gustav. You've been tracking this all day, all week.
That's right, and unfortunately, this is definitely going to be a very destructive storm, still a major hurricane at this point as it continues to churn through the Gulf of Mexico. It moved over Cuba yesterday. That weakened the storm a little bit, but now that it's moving over the warm waters of the Gulf, it has helped to rejuvenate the system. Yesterday, the satellite picture looking a little bit better. We had a very well-defined eye. The eye not there right now, but there is signs that we will be seeing that eye possibly later tonight. Pressure also falling with the system, so an indication that it will be strengthening at least a little bit. However, we're not looking for major intensification. The bottom line, this is going to be making landfall as a major hurricane. Right now it's a Category 3 with winds of 115 miles per hour. Gusts are up to 138. At pressure at 957 millibars. It's moving off toward the northwest at 16 and currently 300 miles southeast of New Orleans. So it will continue on that northwesterly track, projected to make landfall along the Louisiana coast at the earliest late tomorrow morning, possibly tomorrow afternoon. As a major hurricane, again, right now projected to stay a Category 3, so a major hurricane, and then as it makes its way inland, it will be slowing down and slowly weakening, and then we'll be spreading all of that moisture and wind across Louisiana and Texas. Meanwhile, here at home, just a few showers left over. We'll take another look at radar coming up. We'll have the rest of your forecast and the latest on Tropical Storm Hannah.
Sony, thank you. With Hurricane Gustav charging across the Gulf of Mexico, New Orleans residents are leaving by every means possible. The city has issued a mandatory evacuation order, and after the ordeal of Katrina, people are listening. ABC's Marty Johnson reports.
Boarding buses with their suitcases, children, and pet carriers, many New Orleans residents don't even know where they are going.
I'm not afraid, but you don't know where you're going, you know?
They're leaving after the city's mayor warned that Hurricane Gustav is poised to be the mother of all storms.
You need to be scared. You need to be concerned.
And you need to get your butts moving out of New Orleans right now. This is the storm of the century.
Most of the city, both homes and businesses, now boarded up. Hospitals remain open, with the most fragile of patients already evacuated. The mayor says the city will provide no shelter, no services to any residents who try to ride it out. Leaving Washington for Baton Rouge, Homeland Security Chief Michael Chertoff says the federal government will assist in any way possible.
I spoke to the president early this morning at some length about the state of preparations. He is fully committed to throwing all of the assets of the federal government into this fight.
There are, of course, those who will refuse to leave. Many of them are stocking up on supplies of a different kind. Gun and ammunition stores have been doing a crackerjack business with buyers like Samuel Crush, who says he's never owned a gun before.
There is a possibility of vandalism or even stronger danger than that. So on the advice of my wife, I'm making this purchase.
And 1,500 of the city's police.
If you're planning to volunteer and help Gustav evacuees, there are a few things you may want to keep in mind. Cape Fear Volunteer Center Director Annie Anthony says the best thing to do is to wait for instructions from emergency management teams. She said many took initiative to volunteer and help during Katrina without any instruction and did more harm than good. Anthony says one of the worst things we can do is encourage evacuees to come here.
Them going down and bringing people back here is not the best thing for those people, and it's not the best thing for our town. Our town is a vulnerable area, and there's probably going to be another storm just like there was last time.
Shortly after Katrina hit New Orleans, Hurricane Ophelia headed for our region. So did nearly 700 Katrina evacuees. Anthony added that the worst thing anyone can do is invite strangers to stay in their homes. A Wilmington mobile home park was the scene of a murder late Saturday night. News Channel 3's John Rendleman responded to the call, and he has the latest.
Meg, officers were dispatched to Timberland Village just after 11 o'clock last night for a stabbing. That stabbing turned out to be a murder in the middle of the mobile home community off Hooker Road. Arrived on the scene just after 11 Saturday night, they found a 31-year-old man lying dead in the middle of the street in the Timberland Village mobile home park. The victim, a native of Mexico, lived in Wilmington for about 5 years, and he worked in the landscaping business. Residents of the community were tight-lipped on the specifics of the late Saturday night murder, especially to police.
From what I was heard, you know, there's different people that probably saw something, but nobody wants to say anything. They just don't want to get involved.
Investigators searched for clues and witnesses. A woman who lived in the victim's home led everyone to believe she saw what happened, then changed her story and fled the scene. Wilmington police immediately put out a manhunt for her, including a helicopter search. By Sunday morning, that search was over. Wilmington resident Augustine Garcia did not witness the stabbing, nor does he live in Timberland Village, but his stepfather was raised in the same part of Mexico.
Well, like I saw here, I mean, there's, you know, two guys got at it. They were drinking a little bit too much, and they had a little battle.
After witnesses pointed out the suspect, police arrested 45-year-old Robert Mahalko and charged him with first-degree murder. The police report shows Mahalko got into an argument with the victim, threw a beer in the victim's face, and then went back to his trailer to get a knife.
One of them was holding a knife, and the other one was the deceased was, I think he had a screwdriver, I believe. Yeah, from what I know, there was a stabbing to the heart. The tip of the knife stayed inside his heart, from what I heard.
Robert Mahalko is being held at the New Hanover County Jail without bond. Detectives have yet to locate the victim's next of kin. It could be a lengthy delay before his name is released. As we said earlier, he is a native of Mexico. That's probably where most of the family is.
All right, John, thank you for the update. A little girl died yesterday in Onslow County from an accident on the water. Now the Wrightsville Beach Coast Guard is warning boaters of the potential dangers. Masonboro Island is a popular destination for many boaters, but the Coast Guard says it also can be dangerous. The Coast Guard says to make sure if you are pulling people behind the boat, do not do it in high traveled areas like the channel. They say if you want to ski or tube, make sure to find a cove away from all the boat traffic and channel markers. Common violations this holiday weekend: too many people on a boat and too many people riding on the bow of the boat. If you're headed to work, the beach, or a barbecue for your Labor Day by way of Independence Boulevard, you may want to rethink your route. It will be closed from 17th Street to Carolina Beach Road from 5 a.m. to about 11 a.m. tomorrow. The Cape Fear Public Utility Authority will be repairing a water line break. Westbound turn lanes from 17th and eastbound turn lanes from Carolina Beach Roads onto Independence will also be closed. A prominent Wilmington church celebrated two decades in the Port City.
When Brian was 8 years old,
Pastor Ron McGee held and started the non-denominational Rock Church in 1998. He held the first service in the Trask Middle School library. The church prides itself on catering to the poor and bridging racial gaps. At first, there were only 50 congregations. Now, there are hundreds.
We've grown as a church, as a family. We're a church that's a family, and we love each other and just take care of each other.
Today, Pastor Ron stepped down as lead pastor. He passed the reins over to his son, Brian. While many of you may be spending your holiday weekend on the water, others are choosing dry land. Coming up next on News Channel 3 tonight, why some locals choose to enjoy the great outdoors close to home. And later, the hurricane hunters give us a rare look into the eye of Hurricane Gustav.
It's the Toyota National Clearance Event at Toyota of Wilmington. The best time to buy with the biggest savings. Drive a new 08 4Runner with $7,000 off MSRP or 0% for a full 60 months. Want more? How about 08 Tundras and Sequoias with up to $13,000 off MSRP or 0% financing for 72 months? That's huge. Plus, big savings on all remaining 08s. The selection is great, so shop us first.
Great deals on better cars. Toyota of Wilmington.
Surf City Surf Shop, your surfing headquarters since 1978.
When you are wrongfully injured through no fault of your own, life can be tough.
Oasis Legal Finance is the number one choice to provide clients the money they need for bills and living expenses long before their case may settle. Oasis has prepaid millions of dollars over the last 12 months to people just like you, often in as little as 24 hours. There's no obligation to repay if you lose your case. Please make sure to have your attorney's information and call Oasis now.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone. You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Take advantage of the discount and get the 2008 Chevy Silverado with better available V8 fuel economy than Tundra and F-150. That's right. Get this 2008 Silverado half-ton for around $20,500 after all offers.
Many people are spending this Labor Day weekend outdoors camping. News Channel 3's Stephanie Beacon has more on this family tradition that isn't losing popularity despite a struggling economy.
Sure, go ahead.
Travis Snyder has been camping with his family for as long as he can remember.
It's fun, you know. You get to do the campfires and the marshmallows and the s'mores and swimming and fishing and kayaking.
Travis didn't have to travel far for his holiday retreat. He lives in Wilmington, but his family drove 4 hours to visit and spend their vacation together.
I'd rather be doing nothing else. I think it's most important spending time with the family.
Travis says the price is also a plus. His family will be spending $500 during their four-day trip on travel, camping fees, entertainment, and food.
You still save a lot more than staying in a hotel. What hotel are you going to put a little campfire out front and do some s'mores? sense. You know, he's just not going to do it.
Wilmington camping managers say many people agree with Travis. And despite the sluggish economy, the campground's numbers have not changed, with almost 30,000 campers staying each year. The only difference is where they're from. Gas prices may be forcing vacationers to stay closer to home.
We have just seen a significant increase in the amount of locals that have come to stay with us within a four-hour radius. They're not coming from as far.
Campers are also spending longer trips at one site instead of driving from campground to campground.
This is like a little section of heaven. You know, it's a little paradise, and that's the joy of camping.
Regardless of your favorite Labor Day weekend activity, diehard campers will argue that there is nothing better than spending time with family and sitting by the campfire. In Wilmington, Stephanie Beacon, WWAY, News Channel 3.
To stay at the Wilmington campground, it can cost between $30 per night for a tent site and $125 a night to stay in a lodge. One camper we spoke with says she loves camping, but says there are some cons. You still have to make your own bed, clean, and cook. Now to a lady who knows a little bit about that and the weather, here's Sonia with your forecast. Hey, Sonia.
Thanks, Megan. I think I just know a little bit about the weather. Let's just stick with that. We did have scattered showers and thunderstorms across the area this afternoon. Here's how things are looking right now. Some light rain across northeastern Pender County, more rain across southern Brunswick County, and across western Columbus County. Some of that rain is heavy. Some of the thunderstorms we saw earlier were strong, and they had some heavy rainfall associated with them. In fact, some spots did see up to 2 inches of rain. This is where we're going to see the heavier rain at this point, where we're seeing the green. That's where we're dealing with light to moderate rain. Everything is moving off toward the southwest out of the area. A few light showers behind this batch that we're dealing with right now. And I think as we head through most of the evening, things will start to dry out. And don't look for much wet weather if you're going to be out later on, say maybe past 8 or 9 o'clock tonight. And the rain has cooled them down to 73 right now in Whiteville. The rest of us still hanging on to the 80s, 82 in Burgaw and in Wilmington. Meanwhile, 81 in Southport. We made it up close to that 90 degree mark today, 89 the official high in Wilmington. Meanwhile, 73 our low this morning, and we did get a trace of rain, but as I mentioned, some areas saw up to 1-2 inches of rain underneath some of those strong thunderstorms. Everything coming to an end over the next couple of hours this week. Cold front will be sliding through, really not going to do much for us as it finally makes its way out of the area late tonight and early tomorrow morning. Behind it, this high pressure settles in. That's going to set us up for very nice weather as we head into your Labor Day. Meanwhile, here you can see the outer bands of Gustav getting ready to head into parts of the Florida Panhandle and even parts of southern Alabama and southern Mississippi. Now down to the tropics we go. A lot to talk about. Here is Gustav, still a major hurricane. It will be making landfall as a major hurricane along the Louisiana coast tomorrow. Meanwhile, behind it, we've got Hannah, and it's not looking very organized on satellite at this point, and the hurricane hunters did fly into it today for the first time, and here's what they found out. Winds are at 46 miles per hour, gusts up to 58. The system is moving off toward the west at 9 miles per hour and currently about 850 miles south-southeast of Wilmington. So it continues on that westerly track, heads toward the Bahamas the next couple of days, kind of meanders around, and then heads off toward the northwest. And at this point, there is a good chance it could be heading toward the southeastern United States. So we're going to be monitoring this storm every single day here on WWAY. Here are the computer models, and they are definitely in agreement with it taking that northwesterly turn. So our forecast as we head into the end of this week and next weekend, highly dependent on exactly what Tropical Storm Hannah does. At this point, it's battling a lot of winds at the upper levels of the atmosphere, and the system not expected to intensify much over the next couple of days, but we are still going to keep an eye on it. A good area of strong interest for us here in the southeastern United States. So tonight, showers and storms ending early, partly cloudy skies, a low of 70. Then for your Labor Day, things looking nice, mostly sunny and pleasant. A high of 85, lower humidity too. Winds out of the east at 10 to 15. Along area beaches, the rip current risk will be high. We'll have a small craft advisory in effect. And then we stay nice as we head through most of the week, then possible effects from Hannah Friday into Saturday. But tomorrow, unfortunately, a lot of people are going to be at the beach, but keep in mind that small craft advisory in effect if you're going to be boating and the high rip current risk.
Okay, Sonia, thank you.
You bet.
Gustav is threatening the Republican National Convention. Still to come, the latest on how it's feeling the effects of the storm.
It's time to get ready for fall during the Shop Till You Drive clearance event at your Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeep dealers. We're taking up to 40% off MSRP on 08 Rams and up to 22% off MSRP on our fashionable minivans. Check out our selection of fuel-efficient vehicles and find your perfect fit at the Shop Till You Drive clearance event going on now. Or during the Shop Till You Drive event, get 0% financing for 72 months plus $2,000 bonus cash on Aspen.
Well, you see anything that you like?
Hey, Mom, check out the Food Lion deal.
Oh, wow.
Welcome to Binky Dinkies. What would you like?
I'd like a home-cooked meal with extra value, family togetherness, and a side of conversation.
What?
We're going to Food Lion.
Now Food Lion offers dinner for four under $10 with your personal MVP card. Get everything to feed a hungry family for under $10. Shop Food Lion for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. With meals for less, you'll get more savings than ever.
I'm Good.
And I'm Will.
We're from GCF, Goodwill Community Foundation.
Class is back in session.
Here's your first pop quiz.
Do your kids' school clothes from last fall still fit?
If they get a grade of D for don't, put them on the bus to your neighborhood GCF donation center and store.
Your tax-deductible donations help provide free math, computer, and life skills online at learnfree.org.
Get on the honor roll.
Donate to GCF.
Goodwill Community Foundation.
Creating opportunities for a better life.
Hey, Mr. Opportunity here, and if you're seeing me, it's Honda clearance time, which means now's your chance to pick the totally redesigned Accord, the sporty Civic, the fuel-efficient Fit, or any other Honda you yearn for at a deal that can only be described as very desirable.
Looking good, Mr. O.
This job just keeps getting better and better. The 2008 Honda clearance. Get APR financing as low as 0.9% on all new Honda Odyssey models for well-qualified buyers. I'm Mr. Opportunity, and I'm knocking.
Because Hurricane Gustav is heading for the Gulf Coast with the potential for a major disaster, it's also having a major impact on the Republican National Convention. John McCain and his vice presidential choice, Sarah Palin. ABC's TJ Winnick explains.
John McCain and running mate Sarah Palin stopped in at emergency management in Jackson, Mississippi today to check on preparations for Hurricane Gustav.
There's very little doubt that we have to go from a party event to a call for the nation for action.
Late this afternoon, Republican Party officials announced they will go ahead and open the convention Monday, but will suspend most activities. According to the McCain campaign, scheduling for St. Paul will be on a day-to-day basis.
We will begin tomorrow's convention in abbreviated fashion. Chairman Duncan alluded to the fact that there are certain basic minimum requirements of constituting the party and the convention that are required.
Of course, this is a time when we have to do away with our party politics and we have to act as Americans.
While campaigning in Ohio, Barack Obama held back on any criticism of his Republican opponent with regard to the convention and Gustav.
I think that a big storm like this raises bipartisan concerns, and I think for John to want to find out what's going on is fine.
The McCain campaign has chartered a jet to leave Minnesota today and tomorrow to take those delegates whose states might be affected back to the Gulf Coast. TJ Winnick, ABC News, St. Paul, Minnesota.
More on the storm when we return. A look rarely seen at the severe weather as it gains steam on its way toward the Gulf Coast.
It's time to get ready for fall during the Shop Till You Drive clearance event at your Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeep dealers. We're taking up to 40% off MSRP on 08 Rams and up to 22% off MSRP on our fashionable minivans. Check out our selection of fuel-efficient vehicles and find your perfect fit at the Shop Till You Drive clearance event going on now. Or get 0% financing for 72 months plus $4,000 bonus cash on Ram 1500 Quad Cab.
Chevron, $18.7 billion. BP, $20.8 billion. ExxonMobil, $40.6 billion. Big oil companies are making billions at our expense. And where has Elizabeth Dole been? In Washington, taking over $250,000 in campaign cash from big oil and voting to give them billions more in tax breaks. Tell Elizabeth Dole we need lower fuel costs, not billions for big oil.
How you work is what defines you. You
thrive on doing the job right, the White Tractor Company in Burgaw can help you take on the toughest projects. You show pride in a hard day's work. You demand more from yourself than others. That's why you need to drive a Massey Ferguson 500 Series utility tractor from White Tractor. Your work, your tractor, Massey Ferguson. From little tractors to big tractors. White Tractor Company in Burgaw has the tractor for you.
As Hurricane Gustav approaches land, we take a look at what the storm is like as it gains intensity in the ocean. ABC's Jeffrey Kaufman had a chance to fly into the belly of the beast to see what's really going on at its center.
This is what the Gulf has reason to fear. You're looking at the eyewall of Hurricane Gustav as it churns its way northward. And this is the eerily calm eye of the storm.
It's a fairly rapidly intensifying storm. It's now a Cat 2. Do not be surprised if it's a Cat 3 by the time we leave it today.
Good Morning America got an exclusive and stomach-wrenching up-close view of Hurricane Gustav.
Runway 2210608, clear for takeoff.
From inside one of NOAA's Hurricane Hunter airplanes as it took off at 4 a.m. to fly intentionally into the eye of this ferocious storm. The hurricane scientists aboard this sophisticated airborne research lab collect data for computer models that predict the hurricane's path and try to predict its intensity, sending the results as they come in back to the National Hurricane Center in Miami.
Their emphasis of the research is important. So this year, for example, it's all about intensity forecast. And we've really done a great job in NOAA, Weather Service, et cetera, in predicting the track. But predicting the intensity of the storm has been very problematic. In fact, it's almost a flat line.
Satellites, ground radar, and ocean buoys contribute data.
Okay, stand by for drop.
But nothing is more valuable than the hardware on these planes, including probes dropped into the hurricane to measure pressure, wind speed, temperature, and much more.
It's now 5 minutes to six. We've been in the air for just almost 2 hours, and we are 6 miles from the eye wall. We've been told to fasten our seat belts, and they're warning us it's going to be very rough.
Winds are coming off pretty fast.
The NOAA pilots, who delicately steer into the hurricane's eye, affectionately call this plane Miss Piggy. They know people think they're crazy, but NOAA's been doing this for more than 50 years, and the data collected here is one of the main reasons we now know so much about hurricanes. The Hurricane Hunter made three passes through Gustav's eye, each time the storm more powerful.
It's certainly a strengthening hurricane in a hurry.
Ultimately, it is all about predicting the behavior of the hurricane so that people can be warned that harm is on its way. Jeffrey Kaufman, ABC News, MacDill Air Force Base in Florida.
Stay with us. Sonia has one last check of the forecast when we come back.
It's Toyota's national clearance event from the most fuel-efficient full-line car company on the road today. Now, get $4,600 in total savings on new 08 4Runner models. That's $4,600 in total savings. Hurry in now for Labor Day savings.
I'm telling you, Liddy Dole is 93.
93?
Does Kay Hagan think we believe that? Elizabeth Dole's got firepower. She just received the Best of Congress Award. She saved our military bases and thousands of jobs, saved our farmers, and gave sheriffs tools to fight illegal immigration.
She's dedicated her life to helping us.
I'm Elizabeth Dole, and I approve this message.
It's Toyota's national clearance event from the most fuel-efficient full-line car company on the road today. Now get $3,200 in total savings on new 08 Toyota Tacoma double cab models. Hurry in now for Labor Day savings.
Showers winding down over the next hour or so, and a beautiful looking Labor Day. Lower humidity, slightly cooler temperatures, a high of 85, lots of sunshine. Nice weather as we head through Thursday with high pressure in control, and then depending on the track of Tropical Storm Hannah, we could be feeling some effects on that Friday into Saturday, possibly lingering over into Sunday. So we shall see. We'll be watching Hannah very closely over the next couple days.
All right, Sonia, thank you.
You bet.
Here's a look at what's coming up this week on News Channel 3 in the news. We'll take you to Southport's Labor Day celebration and some others across the area. Also, the Republican National Convention starts in Minnesota this week. We'll talk to some local delegates, and Wilmington's new fire chief has his first day Tuesday. We'll check in with Cecil Martinette as he begins his new job as head of the 200-plus member department. And some enterprising twins in Ocean Isle Beach were given the important distinction of Best Lemonade Stand by Inc. Magazine. We'll have those stories and more this week on News Channel 3. And finally tonight, the Oregon Zoo's week-old Asian elephant made his much-anticipated public debut. Rose 2 and her new calf are together in an indoor viewing gallery of the zoo's Asian elephant exhibit. Zoo staffers only admitted 30 people at a time into the viewing gallery for 5 minutes each. The young Asian elephant is still unnamed and was born August 23rd at the zoo. Until the new baby's arrival, Rose 2 herself had been the last elephant born at the zoo. I know you're an animal lover, aww, Sonia, as am I.
That's
so
cute.
Absolutely. I mean, I'm not trying to put you on the spot, but can you think of any names?
I was wondering, are they going to do something Asian?
I don't know, but they do that with
zoo.
Well, they do that with pandas, so I'd imagine they would do that with elephants.
That's true.
I don't know. They have great memories.
Asian names off the top of my head.
I don't either, but we could probably brainstorm a couple.
Hey, we'll come up with some at 11.
Okay.
You have to tune in then to find out.
Yeah. Well, that'll do for News Channel 3 at 6. Thanks for being with us. We'll see you back here at 11.
Introducing one product.